In this short video, I'm going to discuss how you can disable auto-increment in Google Sheets. If you want to learn more about Google Sheets and learn all of the tips and tricks, you can use the Skillshare link in the description below to access the premium courses that are available on the website. So the link in the description below will give you 30 days of free access to all premium courses on the website. So let's jump into this video. I've set up a very basic spreadsheet here using Google Sheets. And the point of this spreadsheet is to really identify the problem that we experience using the auto increment feature and how we can solve that problem. So you can see here that I have set up this month column, and simply by typing the word followed by the number and dragging it down, I can automatically fill out all of the values underneath. So you can see we've got from month 1 right down to month 17 here. And this is quite useful for filling out data really quickly. And most of the time this will help you in order to save time, but there are times when you need to actually disable that feature, and that's what we'll be looking at in this video. So this spreadsheet I've created is an example of what way you may want to calculate the signups on a website. So in this case, I have 500 visitors to my website. I'm estimating a conversion rate of 2%, and the average sale price for the conversion will be $9.99. So this is just to see an example of how we may calculate potential revenue on a website. And not to worry too much about the details of this spreadsheet, but just to give you an example of how we may use this autocomplete and how we can disable it in this case. So I'm going to fill this out. So for month 1, we have 500 visitors. We have 10 sales on the website, and that converts to $99.90. So that's very straightforward so far. We've got the conversion rate. But the problem happens when we try to drag this down. So when we drag this down, you'll see that things go all over the place very quickly. So it doesn't understand what we're trying to achieve here. So let's look at the cell and see what's happening. So we can see that we've got this H5. So that references the H5 column. But we go to the next cell underneath it, then it automatically assumes that the cell will move down that it's copying the value from. And if we open the next column, we can see we've got this equation, and the first cell in the equation is correct. We want it to automatically take the cell for the new row each time. But the right cell is not what we want. We want that to be fixed and actually pull from the value at the top. So we don't want that one to auto-increment each time. So we're going to have a look at how we can fix that now. So we'll delete these values. We'll just keep the first row that we had at the beginning. So we want to get the first row correct, and then we will be able to drag this down and auto-complete everything. So when we open this cell, we can see that the value of this cell is simply the cell that it is copying from. So it's an equal sign followed by the cell number, which is H4. But in this case, we're going to use the dollar sign before the number 4, and that makes that value fixed. So once we drag this down, you will see that the value does not change here at all. So we got this fixed value that doesn't increment. So now we're going to have a look at the next column, so the sales column. And here we have this equation. We've got this cell multiplied by another cell. So we're multiplying two cells together. So the first one will be on the left, which is the visitors on the website. So we want that one to auto-increment by default. But the second one, we want to have a fixed value. So we want it to be fixed, as this is a conversion rate which won't change over time. So this one is just the sell value. So we can have a dollar sign in front of the 5. And now let's look at the revenue column. Here we've got another equation. This time we want to keep the left one as it is, but we want the right column to be fixed. So this is the dollar amount that it is multiplying against. So we want to keep that one fixed. So let's drag this down, this whole row, and see what happens. So we can see that everything is identical. But to make this more interesting, we want to assume that the website visitors will increase every single month. So we're going to double that up. So we'll turn this into a sum. So we'll turn this into an equation, and we'll add the previous value onto itself. So we'll add the cell directly above, which is B4 in this case. And we'll add it onto this fixed number, which is 500. And now if we drag this down, we should get different values each time. So now all of the values are going up over time. assuming that we have more visitors to the website every month, the conversions should also be going up and the revenue should also be going up too. So up until this point, we've only looked at having a fixed number, but you can also make the letter of that cell fixed by doing the same thing. So you can put the dollar sign in front of it. But if you don't do that, it will automatically increment too. So in this case, you can see that the cell number increments if you're going horizontal, if you're dragging horizontally. But if you want to fix that, you can simply put the dollar sign in front of the cell letter. So just showing how that works here, let's put the dollar sign in. So it would be $H, $6. And now once we drag that, it will maintain that letter number. So you can see that the letter is constant now, it is fixed. So that is just in case you need to do any equations horizontally and you want to drag in this way. But most of the time when you're using a spreadsheet, you'll be working down across the rows. So it's normally the number that needs to be fixed rather than the letter. But it's good to know how to do that in case you need to have that letter fixed. So hopefully that all made sense. And now you can actually disable the auto increment on specific cells within your Google Sheets. If you want to learn more about how to use Google Sheets and become an expert in it, make sure to check out the Skillshare link where you can get a 30-day free trial and enjoy all of the premium courses on the Skillshare website. So that link is in the description below. Thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you all in the next one.